Hello, my friends. It is Crystal, and welcome back to my final Christmas decorate with me for 2020. I am out in the kitchen and have a lot of decor to share with you today. You can see it's all over my kitchen counters as well as my kitchen table. But first, I wanted to share with you this cute Santa cookie jar that I found at Goodwill on this day. For $4. He still had the seal on him, so I wanted to get him all washed up and kind of let him air dry while I started working on the rest of the kitchen. But I'm definitely going for the traditional lookout in our kitchen as well. My kids love all things Santa Claus and Christmas, and so I picked him up with them in mind. I just thought he was adorable. Now, today's video is also a collaboration with my friend here on YouTube, Lauren Midgley. Now, she is going to be decorating her hot cocoa bar as well as her dining room area. She shares all things cleaning and decorating on her channel, and she's also expecting baby number 2, and I know you will love her. So I'm going to link her channel down below as well as her video, so you can definitely go watch her video when you are done watching this one. Before I get started decorating though, I am just wiping down all of the counters with the Mrs. Meyer's multi-surface cleaner and the peppermint scent. By far, this is my favorite cleaner for Christmas time, and it's just my go-to in general in the kitchen.
Whatever we do, we will be all right. These holiday wonders will open your mind. May all your wishes tonight come true. The love I live, the dream I know. Well, I'm all for Christmas. It's a magical time full of kisses. Take a walk out.
You know I love to change out my wreath seasonally on our barn door, and so I'm actually using this one that I got last year from Kirkland's. It has some really pretty reds as well as greens in it, and I think it just works perfectly on this wall. And then I'm also using another piece of decor from last year. I found this at a local store. I cannot find it online anywhere. But it is like the perfect size to fit behind the door as it slides open. It is so hard to find different pieces of decor here. So I'm excited to switch out what I've had hanging there for years to something more wintry. Now I'm just going to work my way around our kitchen counters. I have already shared a tiered tray decorate with me, so these are already decorated and they've pretty much stayed the same. I did add one little Fiestaware pitcher. I do collect Fiesta dishes, and so you'll see me use a few of those pieces as I am decorating. Now I will say this is my first run at putting out all of the Christmas decorations. I like to switch things up every year as much as I can to give you some new ideas or inspiration. And so make sure to stay until the very end because I'm going to do like a complete walkthrough, share with you some updates that I make after I get done decorating. It's always good when you're done to just kind of step back, think about if you like how it looks, and make changes as needed. And I definitely did that. So like I said, you'll want to watch till the end and I'll share with you little changes here and there. I did make a few over here as well. But this scale I'm pulling out again now for the Christmas season. It is a Hearth and Hand scale. I've had it for years, but I thought this cute little Santa mug would be perfect on top with a little bottle brush tree inside. I am not sure if you're able to see outside there, but it is snowing and it is just beautiful. It's definitely getting me in the decorating spirit. I was also listening to Christmas music, but I decided to try something new above our sink area. I've never really decorated this part, but I thought I would try this extra garland, and I'm basically just kind of draping it over the blinds.
Thank you.
This chicken wire shelf on our counter is one of my favorite spots to decorate, and usually I keep it pretty minimal as far as decor goes, but I decided to go all out this year and fill it up with all things that I love. I'm using a couple of my Fiesta canisters that I have had. I pull them out kind of seasonally. And then the Mrs. Claus Cookie Company sign is something that I picked up last year from the Target Dollar spot. I loved it so much, I decided to bring it back out and put it in its same spot. As you hand me the call, we got by. Falling just like these snowflakes tumbling down, round and round. A lot of the decor I am using on here are pieces that I've collected over the years. This candy canes dish was one I found from Kirkland's last year. I typically use it on my hot cocoa bar, which I may do one. I'm not quite sure yet, but you all know if I do, I will make sure to share it here on my channel. And then in the little cubbies, it's always kind of fun to find some different things to put in here. So I have these Hearth in Hand little striped bowls, and then a candy cane dish that I have had, oh my goodness, it's probably been 5 years at least. But I love the pops of the red and white paired with just a little bit of green. Just like the snowflakes tumbling down, round and around. I'm falling just like the snowflakes, falling for you, falling for you. And if I were to make a wish upon a star, would it be? I changed my mind on which tray I wanted to use in the kitchen area. This is a Hearth in Hand copper one that I picked up in the fall that I'm definitely planning to use again for this Christmas season. I put a dollar spot little wreath in there and my crushed candy cane Bath and Body Works candle. There's something about this scent that is just so vibrant and brings so much energy, which is definitely something that I need when I am decorating. I do end up making just a few changes over here, so I'll share that in the end though. But I'm moving on to this shelf here that typically has three baskets, but I like to leave the bottom one off so I can hang kitchen towels here. This is the one that I shared in my decor haul, the hot cocoa recipe. Again, changed my mind. That always happens when I buy things. I think I know where they're going, and then when it comes to decorating, I completely change my mind. But anyways, I'm just filling up the other baskets with a couple of pieces from the Target Dollar spot. The kids kind of sit here right by these baskets, so I keep it as child friendly as I can, and I thought they would love that little Santa Claus gnome. Oh, oh, ain't you ringing my bells no more. I don't love him, that's for sure. Lots of decor to go, as you can see, and I am excited to get these shelves decorated. Now, in previous years, I've gone very minimal, I would say. But this year, my plan is to add more greenery and also kind of that deep green to a lot of the red and white that I've done the previous year. So really bringing both the green and red traditional colors over here. And I want this space to feel just very cozy and warm, displaying cookbooks, canisters, that kind of thing. I treat these kind of like hutch decor, and I love how it turns out. I'm excited to share it with you. But this is a Hearth in Hand cake stand. I'm just adding a couple of these flocked mini wreaths that you can find at Walmart. These are great for decorating hutches. You can stack them between bowls. I decided to stick mine in my cake stand. Target has these melamine, is that how you say it, plates. They're $3 each, and I thought it was the perfect pop of green for this area, and it's very easy just to lean it against there. And I'm so excited I can finally display this Mrs. Claus canister. This was a special gift from a subscriber last year. A lot of the decor that I use on these shelves came from Target. I've just kind of collected it over the years. That joy sign is something I've had for years. It's probably one of my favorite pieces of decor. I just love it right there. It always goes there. I seriously have an obsession with the joy signs. I cannot buy any more next year. You guys remind me of that. But to the bottom shelf, I'm adding a Hearth in Hand cookie canister. And that Merry Christmas Buffalo check bin came from Kirkland's last year. I store like napkins and Kleenex in there. It's kind of a cute way to hide it, but also very practical for us. As always, I will try to link down below in the description box as much as I can from today's video, but I wanted to share this fun find with you. I know I'll get questions on it. It's probably one of my favorite things that I'm displaying in the kitchen this year, and it is this set of three Christmas buckets. I have one of them with the rolling pins in it right there, and you'll see me use the other two in other areas out here, but I am obsessed. Now, those came from houseandhome.com. I talked about her website in my Christmas haul, and that was the one item that I knew I wanted to pick up, so I was very excited to get those. So I'll have her website linked down below. But now I'm moving on to my little glass canisters. This snowman, I decided to stick a little garland in him because I didn't really think that we needed marshmallows over here. And then for the Santa Claus, I'm just putting in all of these mini candy canes to give a little pop of red, and I know my kids will love this. Let's have a toast for the lovers. We'll tumble round in the snow. And my heart's going boom, boom, boom. You're so beautiful. Talking on the phone, I make you feel at home. Oh, when I got you by my side, what a night. Jolly. in the kitchen for Christmas time. I love to decorate with cookie cutters, and so I'm just adding all of my Christmas ones into this canister that is from Target. It kind of has many uses in my kitchen. Sometimes I do have cookies in there. For fall, I have pumpkins, but I thought this was too cute, and it kind of filled the gap that I had in my shelf. To the wall, I am adding this metal Merry Mail sign. This is something I bought last year from Kirkland's. This is where we display all of our Christmas cards. But because it's so early, we haven't received any quite yet. I'm just hanging one of the little Target dollar spot wreaths to help fill that in there. And then over here on this window pane, this is a Hobby Lobby spring section window. I'm adding a Walmart wreath. The final space I would like to decorate with you in today's video is above our sideboard. We have a shiplap wall over here, and so I do like to keep things simple over here, but again, this year I want to take it up a notch, and so we're going to try something really fun, I think. So first I'm just wiping everything down, and I always have my dough bowl here. It's basically a large wooden bowl, and for many years I've always done just greenery in it. But this year I thought I would mix things up and try to create a Christmas village inside of it, because I've had so many of the Target dollar spot houses that I've collected over the year, and I thought it would be a fun way to display them. Feels like I'm a kid, like I'm forever young. And that's why I wanna sing about the Christmas on its way. I'm basically just putting some scrap wood from out in our garage in the bottom of it to create a level space to put all my little houses. And I'm using my little Hobby Lobby garland in here as well to help kind of cover it up, almost look like snowballs. And now I'm just lining up all of these little houses. Again, I've just kind of collected these as Target has them. They do have more of them this year, so you could definitely recreate this look. And then I'm going to be adding some flocked greenery. This actually came from the Target Wonder Shop. People singing about love. It feels like I'm a kid, like I'm forever young. And that's why I wanna sing about the Christmas on its way. A reason to hang around and celebrate this day. Everyone's smiling. It's the time of year, winter wonderland, my winter wonderland. It's the time of year, my winter wonderland, my winter wonderland. To my little village, I'm going to add these globe lights that I also found at Target, and these are so neat. They almost look like little bubbles, but they make this village just glow at night. It is so pretty. I'm happy you're here. My winter wonderland. Oh, my winter wonderland. Oh, my winter wonderland.
among all the tinsel and lights, I'm strolling around. Just wondering where you have gone to. Are you just around the corner or in Kathmandu? And whether or not you're with somebody new, still I wish you the merriest Christmas. I hope.
So I pretty much have all of the main spaces decorated now, and as you can see, I'm starting to kind of rearrange things and kind of think if I want to move anything, if I'm happy with how it looks. And so I'll give you close-ups of everything here in just a minute, but I have just a little bit of cleanup that I still need to do. Of course, when you're decorating with Christmas pieces, there's flocked mess everywhere, glitter, and then there's always a few extra pieces that just can't find homes for. So I'm going to clean all of that up. And then I also have a little garland to hang on our light fixture above the table. It's the same one I used last year, but it's just a very simple one that the Target dollar spot had.
A beautiful wife, two kids, and a dog pup. Still sometimes I wonder if you're near or off yonder, though I couldn't tell you why. But wherever
whenever I share my little handheld vacuum, I always get questions on it. So I wanted to give a shout out to my little Shark handheld vacuum. I love this thing for quick cleanups. I use it all of the time. Highly recommend it. I will also link this down below as well. But that's going to be it for today's video. I'm going to share with you all of the close-ups now and a look at our entire kitchen area. I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching today's video. I truly appreciate it. And I'm so glad I can share it with you here on my channel. But coming up here on Monday, I'm going to be sharing a full Christmas home tour. I'm sharing spaces you have seen me decorate that I've maybe changed a little bit, and also some new spaces that I have not shared at all. So you'll definitely want to stay tuned for that, as well as a big giveaway that will also be in that video. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. Go watch Lauren's video right now. I'll have her channel linked down below in the description box, and I will see you back here on Monday. Bye. Thank you.